Dear students, welcome to the new lecture in the series of quantum chemistry. So far, we have seen about the failures of classical mechanics. Then we have seen about the principles of quantum chemistry given by de Broglie, Heisenberg, and the Schrodinger's wave equation for time dependent and time independent. Then we had seen about the postulates of quantum chemistry, operators, the concept of operator on dynamic variable, as well as the Hermitian operators. Further, we had seen about the particles, free particle moving in any directions, then the particle in one dimensional box, and also the particle in three dimensional box in the last lecture. Now we will apply these principles, whatever we have studied so far, on real systems like harmonic oscillator. In this lecture, we will engage the applications of quantum chemistry on harmonic oscillator. That is, whenever a bond is vibrating, when the bond is vibrating, it will be vibrating like an harmonic oscillator. So how this quantum mechanical principles can be applied to this system, which is representing a bond movement.
Drawing is not so good, so आपको just imagine करना है. Still more or less better. We don't require this particular part. So this can be taken as origin as zero. Here we can take it as plus A, which is our x-axis, and this can be taken as minus A. This let it be our potential energy. So it is our potential energy curve. This is our potential energy curve. We are representing it over here. Harmonic oscillator, like we can have it as an example of a pendulum. जो pendulum वाले clocks शायद ही आप लोगों ने देखे होंगे कहीं मूवीज वगैरह पुरानी मूवीज में यू कैन सी इट एज अ पेंडुलम क्लॉक्स. बाकी आजकल तो घरों में बहुत कम पेंडुलम क्लॉक्स यूज होते हैं. तो दैट पेंडुलम क्लॉक या फिर आपका अगर किचन हो तो किचन को जस्ट पकड़ के आप जो चाबी को घुमाते हो इन ए टू एंड फ्रो मोशन, सो दैट विल बी योर लाइक अ हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेशन. तो अ परफेक्ट हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेशन विल बी वन which will be if यहाँ से हमारा पार्टिकल अगर इस तरफ में हम रखते हैं और लाते हैं वापस तो इट विल बी जस्ट मूविंग इन दिस पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शंस कंटिन्यूअसली एंड इट विल नॉट फेस एनी फ्रिक्शन एंड सो इट विल बी मूविंग इट फॉर इनडेफिनेट टाइम अंटिल एंड अनलेस वी हैव वी अप्लाई एन ऑपोजिट फोर्स इट विल रिमेन एज सच इन दैट पर्टिकुलर मोशन. सो दिस द पोटेंशियल एनर्जी फॉर दिस ऑसिलेशन the potential energy of oscillation at any given point is given by V is equal to minus integration of f of x dx from 0 to x. From 0 to x, we have f of x equals minus kx for this type of motions. F of x equals to minus kx, because this minus sign we are having it as the amount of force that is required to stop the motion. मोशन उसको हमें स्टॉप करने के लिए जो फोर्स लगेगा दैट फोर्स वी कॉल इट एज दैट इज गिवन बाय दिस एफ ऑफ एक्स क्यूब सो इट विल बी इन अ नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन बिकॉज ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन में हमें वो फोर्स अप्लाई करना होता है सो व्हेन वी सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस माइनस के एक्स ओवर हियर वी विल गेट इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ माइनस इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ minus kx from 0 to x dx. This minus minus sign gets cancelled. We'll have integration from 0 to x kx dx. This will be giving us integration of kx with respect to x will be kx square by 2. We have A will be equal to 4 pi square mu square m. This we can have it as k because we have it for oscillation. The frequency of that oscillation frequency, vibrational frequency, we have it as 1 upon 2 pi under root k upon m. 1 upon 2 pi under root k upon m. So if we square it, we will have mu square equals 1 upon 4 pi square k by m. If we transfer this 4 pi square m over here, we will get k is equal to 4 pi square m mu square. So if we substitute this over here as k, we will get 4 pi square m mu square x square upon 2. That is 2 pi square m mu square x square. That will be our potential energy along the x axis. So that this potential energy for this harmonic oscillator we can substitute in our Schrodinger's wave equation. This potential energy we can substitute in our Schrodinger wave equation. For that purpose, what we can do is we can first substitute this in our Hamiltonian. So the Hamiltonian operator for harmonic oscillator is given by the equation remains same, that is h cap equals minus h square upon 8 pi square m del square or d square by dx square plus v along one axis, that is along x axis only. We are watching for the motion along x axis only of the particle. So we are depicting it in this way. So v we can substitute as 2 pi square m mu square x square. So we will have this as minus x square upon 8 pi square m d square by dx square plus 2 pi square m mu square x square. This will become our Hamiltonian operator. We know that Schrodinger equation is h psi is equal to e psi. H psi is equal to e psi. So what we can have here is our h psi minus e psi is equal to 0. We can have substitute this Hamiltonian operator over here. We will get d square psi by dx square plus 8 pi square m upon h square into e minus 2 pi square m mu square x square of psi is equal to 0. This will be our Schrodinger wave equation for harmonic oscillator. Now, if you want to simplify this equation, then we will need to put some substitutions so that the equation becomes now more simpler. We can have two substitutions. Let us have substitutions for simplification as alpha equals 8 pi square me upon x square. This part, that is 8 pi square m upon h square, when multiplied by e, this will become our alpha. And when this 8 pi square m upon h square is multiplied by this potential energy, that we can get it as beta part. A part of it can be taken as a beta part. So, and beta equals 4 pi square mu m upon h. So that beta square now becomes 16 pi to the power of 4 mu square m square upon h square. Now, if we take this equation 1 and expand it by taking out this bracket, we will get equation 1 can be written as d square psi by dx square plus 8 pi square m e upon x square minus 8 into 2, 16 pi to the power of 4 m square mu square x square upon x square psi. Equals 0. This becomes our equation number 2. If we substitute this values of alpha and beta square in this equation number 2, we get substituting alpha and beta in equation 2. D square psi by dx square plus alpha minus, and here this will be bracket because psi is common for both of them. So this is alpha minus, now this will be our beta square x square, beta square x square into psi equals 0. This becomes our equation number 3. We have simplified a longer equation into shorter one, d square psi by dx square plus alpha minus beta square x square psi equals 0. Now, what we have, we can consider that y is equal to, say, a function of beta and x, such that y is equal to under root beta x. Y is equal to under root beta x. Therefore, what we will get, x is equal to y upon under root beta. So for smaller changes, we will have dx equals dy by under root beta. Beta is a constant, so it will not change, but dx will be a small change in x equals small change in y upon square root of beta. If we transfer this dy over here, we will get dx by dy will be equal to 1 upon under root beta. If we do the square on both the sides, that is dx square upon dy square, this will be equal to 1 upon beta. If we square it, this square root of beta will become beta. So you'll get d square dx square by dy square as beta. Similarly, we can write d square psi by dx square as d square psi by dx square into dy square upon dy square. We are just multiplying and dividing by dy square. We exchange this dy square over here. We will get d square psi by dy square into dy square by dx square. So that now this dx square by dy square is 1 upon beta. So dy square upon dx square will be equal to beta. So this will become our beta, and that is d square psi by dy square into beta. So our d square psi by dx square will be equal to beta into d square psi by dy square. What we are doing is we are just changing the variable from x to y. This y is not the y axis, but it is a different y, just a different constant, different variable, such that y is equal to under root beta into x. So if we put this value of d square psi by dx square in our equation number 3. Equation number 3 में हमारा पहला starting में d square psi by dx square है. उसकी जगह पे हम वो डाल सकते हैं. And also we can put this beta square x square there. We can put here x we have it as y upon under root beta. So x square will be equal to y square upon beta. X square will be equal to y square upon beta. So one beta will get cancelled. It will be beta y square will be happening. That is, we have it over here. X equals y upon under root beta. So x square is y square upon beta. So beta square x square will be equal to beta square into y square upon beta. One beta gets cancelled. It will be beta into y square. So we can substitute that beta square y x square over here as by y, and this also we can substitute, so that the equation now will be in the variable of y, not the x. So now we can substitute this in equation 3. We get d square psi by dx square will become beta d square psi by dy square plus alpha minus beta y square of psi will be equal to 0. Now, if we divide it by beta, this beta will cancel, this beta will cancel. It will be alpha upon beta. So d square psi by dy square plus alpha upon beta minus y square psi equals to 0. Let this be our equation number 4. Now this equation is variable in y. It is a purely algebraic equation because यहाँ पे हमारा ये है differential term है, यहाँ पे हमारा y square term है, और ये हमारा alpha upon beta है, जहाँ पर की कोई x या y terms नहीं है. Alpha और beta के definitions में हमने x y terms नहीं लिए थे वहाँ पर, so this will become a constant. Alpha upon beta will now become a constant. So this equation, that is equation number 4. Is purely algebraic equation. But is not an easy equation to solve. So an asymptomatic solutions can be prepared for this, such that we can obtain the solution for such equation by taking very large values of variable. That is very large values of y, because our variable here is y. So we can take very large values of y, that is when y is much greater than alpha upon beta. Y is much larger than alpha upon beta, such that alpha upon beta becomes negligible. So that equation now reduces to b square psi by dy square minus y square psi. Equation now will be reduced, that is equation 4 reduces. This is just assumptions that we are taking it in order to solve this equation. So equation 4 reduces to b square psi by dy square minus y square psi equals 0. Here, such that alpha upon beta is negligible. Alpha upon beta becomes negligible. So equation number 4 can reduce this, and the solutions for this can be, this equation's solutions, you can easily obtain it. The solutions of above equation can be written as y or psi is equal to e to the power of plus or minus y by 2. E to the power of plus or minus y square by 2. But here, the two solutions are there. Of these two solutions, one is acceptable and the other is not acceptable. That is, psi equals e to the power of plus y square by 2 is not acceptable, because we have taken the conditions for acceptability of solution. Because conditions for acceptability of solutions were conditions of well-behaved psi, where that it should never reach infinity. It should never reach infinity, should be continuous. If you remember this, we have taken this, then it should be single value. So these conditions must be satisfied. लेकिन यहाँ पर जब हम y को बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ाते हैं, that is y, when y tends to infinity, as y square tends to infinity, psi also goes to infinity. जैसे y infinite होता है, वैसे ही psi भी हमारा infinite हो जाता है. If y is going for plus or minus infinity, y square will become infinity, and so psi will become infinity. Hence, this solution is not acceptable. But when we take the second part of this, that is plus or minus, minus part, when we take it, e to the power of minus y square by 2, this is acceptable solution. ये आपको physical chemistry के practicals जब होंगे तो वहां पर आपको प्लॉटिंग करना है. सो दिस सजेस्ट दैट द सॉल्यूशन फॉर इक्वेशन नंबर 4, सॉल्यूशन फॉर इक्वेशन 4 कंटेन्स e to the power of minus x square by minus y square by 2. It is containing this particular term. Iske saath mein aur bhi hoga, because we have assumed that y, alpha upon beta is lesser. Actual mein hota hai ya nahi hota hai, ye hame pata nahi hai. Humne sirf wo assume kiya tha, isliye hame ye ek solution mila. So ye ek solution jo hai, वो उसका जो टोटल ओवरऑल सॉल्यूशन का पार्ट होगा, लेकिन हमें ओवरऑल सॉल्यूशन अभी तक नहीं मिला है. तो इट मे कंटेन दिस पर्टिकुलर टर्म एंड कैन बी रिटन एंड द सॉल्यूशन कैन बी रिटन एज solution can be written as psi is equal to some function f of y into e to the power of minus y square by 2. Let this be our equation number 5. ये e to the power of minus y square by 2 हमें यहाँ से ऊपर से मिला, and f of y is some other term which we have to determine.
Students, we will stop here for this lecture with this derivation. In our next lecture, we will see about the completion of the solution for the equation 5 that we have got, that is psi equals f of y e to the power of minus y square by 2. So we will try to solve this equation in our next lecture.